Hi, how is everyone doing today? Today is Wednesday the 21st. I hope everybody's having a blessed week so far. We have been studying in our devotion book for the last couple of weeks, and last time we were in Psalms 4, where we know that David was still asking for prayer and over his enemies, because his enemies still wanted to hurt him and wanted to kill him, so we know he was praying to God. We also know there was a verse in Psalms 3 and 5. I lay me down and slept. I await for the Lord. Subside me. And that was a verse that we're supposed to say every morning before we go to bed. And also we had one that to say every night before we went to bed that, you know, he wanted us to remember saying every night before bed, pray that we will do something for the poor people that you know and don't know. We remember that it's a verse 4:8. I will both lay me down in peace and slept, for thy Lord only makes me dwell in safety. And now we're on Psalms 5 today, and we're going to go in and we're going to find out what's still going on in the chapters. We know that chapter 3 is a morning song that David wrote. And we know that Psalms 4 was meant for a prayer that you say at night before you go to bed. So we know that those two things is what he was talking about in that. Thank everybody for watching my videos and still continuing to listen to me. I appreciate it and thank God for it. We're going to say a prayer and we'll get into our Bible study. Dear Lord Jesus, I come to you today and give you thanks and the glory. Bless us as we read your word, God. Lift us up and help the Holy Spirit and guide us. Help the Holy Spirit speak through me. And God, you speak through me and help me teach others about your word and what you want to let us, what you want us to learn today. Help us grow in your knowledge, dear Lord. Thank you for waking us up this morning, and thank you for everything you've done for us. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, it's Psalms 5 that we're starting in today. Give ear to me, give ear to my words, O Lord. Consider my meditation. Hearken unto the voice of my cry, my King and my God, for unto thee will I pray. My voice shall thou hear in the morning. O Lord, in the morning will I direct my prayer unto thee, and will look up. For thou art not a God that hath pleasure in weakness, neither shall evil dwell with thee. The foolish shall not stand in the sight that hatest all workers of iniquity. Thou shalt destroy them that speak leasing. The Lord will abhor the blood and discerning men. But as for me, I will come into the house of the multitude of the mercy, and in the fear will I worship towards the holy temple. Lead me, O Lord, in thy righteousness because of my enemies. May the way straight before my face. For there is no faithfulness in their mouth. They are inward part of their wickedness. Their throat is open scarlet. They're flattered with their tongues. Destroy thy, O God, let them fall by their own counsel. Cast them out of the multitude of their transgressors, for they have rebelled against thee. But let all those that put their trust in thee rejoice. Let them ever shout of joy because of defense. Let them also that love the name be joyful in thee. For the Lord wilt the blessing, righteousness with favor, wilt thy compassion, him with a shield. So, as we read that, we're going to go through each verse. Psalms 5, 1-3 is, David told the Lord he will pray every morning. Christians must pray like David. It's important to pray every morning. It's important to look and wait for the answer. David said, I will watch and I will pray. So it's important for us to pray every morning, you know, And as Christians, we should pray every morning and we should ask God, you know, what we need to be blessed with that day, or ask, you know, thank God for waking us up in the morning. You know, ask God, you know, to help us go on with our day and, you know, to keep us where we need to be in that day. Because, you know, anything can happen in the moments as you wake up, you know. Spilled coffee in your clothes, you're just not having a good morning. So, you know, pray to God when you wake up in the morning. Ask God to help you and guide your day when you get up in the morning. That's what's going on in verse 1 and 2. David told the Lord he will pray every morning. So that's what we're talking about, verse 1 and 2. He told the Lord he will pray every morning, which we know as Christians we should pray every morning, and we know we should watch and pray. Be patient. Wait on the Lord to give you your answer. And then we have verses 4 and verses 4 and 6. And for there are not a God that hath pleasure in weakness, nor shall evil dwell with thee. These are talking about David's enemies. They were not enemies of David. They were actually enemies of God, because they didn't. Because being an enemy of David, David was doing what God said. So they're actually disobeying God, because David was listening to God. So they're actually enemies of God. They're not actually enemies of David. David said, God will destroy them. They're destroying themselves. Housley wrote part of the Bible and saying that they will destroy ourselves. We do not ask for God's help. We do not ask for God's help. Even enemies of God ask for help. Then they will become friends. So we need to ask God to help our enemies. We need to pray to God to help them help our enemies. Because, you know, they are going to destroy ourselves. And we know that God is a loving God. And we don't want anybody to be destroyed. We want them to go towards God. So that's verses 4 through 6. And verse 5, the foolish shall not stand in the sight. Thou hast all works of iniquity. They shall destroy themselves and speaking less. The Lord will abhor the blood and discernly man. So that's what they're saying, that, you know, David was explaining to God, you know, that about his enemies. And then God came to him and said, they're not your enemies. They're my enemies too. They're God's enemies. And then we have verse 7 and 8. But as for me, I will come into the house and multitude in the mercy and in the fear. I will worship towards the holy temple. David did not stay in the temple. He lived in a tent. And the tent he lived in was made out of goat skin. You know, verse 5, 8. Lead me, O Lord, in thy righteousness, because of my enemies. Make the way straight before my face. So a straight path means a good path. Straight path means a good path. So let's try to continue going straight so we can have a good path. Even though your enemies are getting you off of track, remember to go pray to God. Remember to pray to God every morning. Remember to pray to God every night. Even in between your days, remember to pray. We're supposed to watch and pray, as David was saying. Righteous is a special Bible word. Lead me in your righteousness means help me obey you, God. Enemies are making it difficult for me to obey you. So a lot of times we do get discouraged because we have people that, you know, that do things a little different than we do, or they don't believe in God like we do, or they do certain things that we do. And the best way to go about it is to pray and ask God to help those enemies. Go to God and ask to help those enemies that you know that you're having complications with, because it can help. It can get you discouraged and it can take you off the path. So, and that's what God wants you to do. God wants you to stay on the right path. And it does make it difficult for you to obey God, because if somebody makes you so angry and disappointed, you're going to end up doing something you shouldn't be doing that you know that's wrong, that God doesn't want you to do. That's verses 7 through 8. Then we have 9 and 10. For there is no faithfulness in their mouth. Their inward part is very wickedness. Their throat is an open sculpture. Their flatter with their tongues. Destroy them, O God. Let them fall by their own counsel. Cast them out of the multitude of their transgressors, for they have rebelled against thee. And as it explains, going through the verse, open grave has dead bodies. And it says, their mouth is like an open grave. Because they're not nice. What they say is not nice. So a lot of times, you know, when we have enemies, they say mean things. They say things that are not nice. They say things that hurt our feelings. And, you know, let's pray about it. Because a lot of times we do get our feelings hurt by our enemies. Or, you know, they're saying things behind our back that we don't like. So let's remember to pray. And verse 11 and 12. But let all these that put their trust in thee rejoice. Let them ever shout of joy because thou defeated them. Let them also that love thy name be joyful in thee. For the Lord wilt because the righteousness, with favor with thy compassion, him as with a shield. Lord is around all the people that he loves. He loves his enemies too. He don't just love us. He still loves his enemies. He doesn't stop loving. God is a good God. He does not love you for whatever you do. He loves you. He loves you because he gave his only son. So obviously we know that he loves us. I pray to God that you know that he loves us. Even no matter what you're doing, he loves you. You can still fall on your knees and you can still go to him. Even if you're doing something that he dislikes, get on your knees and repent and ask God in your heart and believe and trust in Jesus Christ that he is your Lord and Savior. So he is like 11 and 12. He is like a cover over them that stop people from hurting them. Making people happy, even when enemies are near. So he's always going to protect us, even when we have enemies that are near. And he's always going to still love those enemies. And he's going to try to help them. And let's pray for them so that they can get help. A couple key words for the righteous, because it's explaining righteous to us. The word righteous, it's four different things. It tells us about God. It means that he has never done anything that is wrong. He has never broken his own rules. He always done what is right. Even though only God is really righteous, he calls his friends righteous. It does not mean that they are good. It means that they have asked God to forgive them. The word forgive means to give away. God gives away all the sin of the people that he forgives to Jesus. Jesus takes it away. This happens when Jesus died on the cross at the Calvary. But some people's strange way that we cannot understand. Jesus took our sins away. Our sins are the things that we do that are wrong. The things that we do that do not obey God's rules. When Jesus died, he took away the sins of the people. They lived before him and they lived after him. That includes us if we ask. The people of God forgives usually try to obey God. They do what he tells them to do. This is also being righteous in the Bible. When they fall, they pray again. God forgave me. God will always forgive us when we ask him. In the Old Testament, the Jews tried to obey Torah. This was all the rules in the Old Testament. Most of them were in the first five books of the Bible. The Jews called them Torah. Later, the other book, like Isaiah and Jeremiah, were also called Torah. Jews that kept the rules were called righteousness. That the meaning of the word is not important for Christians today. They are righteous for reasons 2 and 3. Righteous people have what the Bible calls righteousness. It means that they have asked God to forgive them. It does not mean that they are very good. It means that they are friends of Jesus because they have asked him to take away their sins. So as we read that and we understand about being righteous, is that we know that Jesus died on the cross for him, us. We know that our sins are forgiven. And we know in this life we live, we're still going to make mistakes. We're still going to have our ups and downs. We're not going to be perfect. But if we fall to our knees and we ask God and we ask Jesus to forgive us, Jesus is going to take away those sins. That is us showing righteousness. That is us showing that we want to be better people, that we want to live for God. And we're not going to be perfect and we're not going to do it every day, but we know that we are trying, and God sees that we're trying, because every time we do something wrong, we go to him and we ask him to forgive us. That's the key to being righteous, as knowing you're doing wrong and going to God and asking him to forgive you, going to Jesus and getting on your knees and asking him to forgive and take that sin away. Remember that. And some things that we're going to, something to do. Pray to the Lord Jesus every morning. Pray for the people that hurt you. Ask God to show them that you are not right. Remember, God loves them as well as you. He does not want them to destroy themselves. He wants them to become his friend. Pray that they will become friends of God. So when you have enemies and you have people that are discouraging you or are making you upset, remember to go to God and pray for that person to help them stop being mean to you, stop being hateful to you, stop hurting your feelings. Go to God and ask God to take that meanness and that anger away that they have, because that gets really discouraging and that can make you not stay in that straight path if you're having somebody that's constantly on your back and constantly hurting you. But remember, God is working. He might not be working when you want him to work, but he is working. So we've got to remember patience. We got to remember trust, because God knows what he's doing, and he knows when he's going to do it right on time. I'm going to read what we have in here, and then we'll be done. There's something special about the morning, isn't there? It's the promise of a whole new day, wherein you can start a new program, begin new projects, resume old relationships, a time of being again whatever you have failed at achieving before. A great hope and promise successful awaits us each morning as we rise from bed. The Lord views morning as special. He desires us to talk with him each morning to help plan our day as he would like us to do. Verse 3 tells us to begin each day with a prayer. It is a good one to follow before you begin the duties of your day. Verse 7 reminds us of great importance of attending church. We will need to fellowship of others, believers, and the preaching of the pastor to help us in our daily walk with the Lord, to say in the righteousness as we live each day. No one has made it regardless of godliness. We all need to improve, don't we? Let the prayer of verse 8 be yours today. Lead me, O Lord, in righteousness. Make thy way straight before my face. The rewards of righteousness through accepting Jesus Christ as your Savior is not only eternal life in heaven with God, but it is also God's blessing here on earth too. He promises in verse 12 that he will be the righteousness with favor, will thy compassion him and with shield. I want God's shield around me today, would not you? Verse 11 tells us to be happy. How can you be like in the Winnie the Pooh stories, all depressed and down and dumped, and at the same time being righteous Christians with God shall protecting you. As you begin your day, it doesn't go together, doesn't it? God tells us to rejoice, be joyful, even shout for joy. Have you ever been so overcome with the wonderful of God's love for you that you want to shout for joy? It's the great feeling of content, joy that God wants us to have each and every day of our lives, knowing that he is our defender against anything that comes our way, that remember that whatever may happen to you today, not a surprise to God. He has the correct shield in place and his defense is sure. Trust him completely and you will experience the true joy. I'm going to read this and then we'll be almost done. Help me today, Lord, to be the total dependent upon you. Help me to take time each morning to pray to you before I start my day. Keep me ever joyful in the knowledge of your great protection of me. So, the key thing is to remember to wake up every morning to help God with your day, to help him plan out your day and help you stay on the right path is what God David is telling us in this chapter, and make sure that we go to God and we pray for our enemies. So, you know, and you know, don't let them discourage us and get us off that path. I pray that everybody has a blessed week. Like I said, today is Wednesday the 21st. We are looking at 4 more days till Christmas, and I pray that everybody knows that we're celebrating Christmas because of Jesus Christ. He was born, and then he died for us to save us from our sins. So as we go into Christmas, let's remember to be thankful. Let's remember to sing Jesus happy birthday. Let's remember to thank his Father God for giving his Son, you know, to die for us, you know, to take away our sins. So let's remember that this Christmas, when we celebrate Christmas, when you get up in the morning to open presents with your family or your kids, take some time out and say a prayer before you open your presents. Take some time out and tell Jesus what you want to give him, because, you know, this is his day. It's not about the gifts. It's not about the money. It's about, you know, giving to others. It's about, you know, giving to God and, you know, giving to Jesus and giving thanks for what he's done for us. I will try to get back with you guys after Christmas, because probably going to be busy Thursday and Friday, but if I'm not, I will try to come back and I will try to do some more Bible study before Christmas gets here. I thank everybody for listening. If anybody has any prayer requests, please write them down. I will pray for you. And even if you don't write any prayer down, I still pray for all my listeners and I still pray for everybody anyways. I love like God loves. We'll go to a word in prayer and we'll be dismissed. Dear Lord, I thank you for the Bible study today. It was a blessing to hear your word and to know that you are our shield and that you protect us from everything and that we can go to you and we can run to you when we need things. God, I pray for my listeners. They have a blessed Christmas. I pray that they put you and your Son first and give thanks for what you've done for us. I pray for the world. I pray for our new president that we'll have. And I pray for all the children and everybody in the world that they have a blessed Christmas and to know that you are God and that you are with us always. Thank you for this Bible lesson. Thank you for letting me share my prayers and my thoughts and your word with the world. Thank you, God. You are truly a blessing, and I give you the glory, and I give you the thanks for everything you do. In Jesus' name, amen.